Today we'll combine this girl and this TV to create the pop-out effect. Hello and welcome to an Affinity Revolution tutorial. Today we'll be learning how to make the pop-out effect. For this tutorial, you'll need this image of a TV and this image of a girl jumping in the air. I've included a link to both of these images in the video description. The first thing we need to do is select the girl. We can do this by using our selection brush tool, the fourth tool down on the left side. So click on that and begin painting a selection over the girl. So just do your best to get a rough selection of her. It doesn't have to be perfect. We're going to adjust it in just a moment. Okay, that looks pretty good to me. The next thing we're going to do is refine our selection, which we can do by pressing Refine. Now all we need to do is paint around the edges of the girl. This is especially important when working around her hair, so just paint right along the edge of her hair, and then Affinity Photo will improve the selection. Okay, that looks pretty good. Now I'm gonna do the same thing around her thumb. I'll paint around that. And then I'll come down by her foot and paint around that. All right, that's looking pretty good. Now all we need to do is press Apply, and we have the girl selected. Next, we're going to mask out the background, which we can do by pressing on the mask icon, this button that looks like a Japanese flag. And now all of the background has been covered up by a mask. We're going to bring this girl into our picture of the TV. To do this, we need to press on the image of the girl and then press Command C, come over to the TV picture, and press Command V. Now we're going to resize and position the girl. To do this, press on the Move tool, this black arrow, and then move the girl to somewhere in the center of the picture and make her smaller by dragging on this corner box and continue resizing and positioning her until she is covering the TV. Let's see, maybe a little bit bigger, drag her a little bit more over. Okay, that looks pretty good to me. To make it look like the girl is inside of the TV and not just jumping in front of it, we're going to mask out the bottom of her legs. We can do this by first pressing on the mask icon, this black and white image over here, and then pressing B, B for brush, and begin painting away the bottom of her legs. I'm going to zoom in a little bit by pressing Command Plus. And then make sure I do a good job along the edge of the TV. That looks great. Now I'm going to press Command 0 so I can see my entire photo. And things are looking really good. We're just going to add one last touch to make the photo look even better. We're going to add a drop shadow to the girl by pressing on her image right here and then coming down to the FX and selecting Outer Shadow. Once you have that selected, make sure that you check it on, and we can drag this box to the side so we can see our image. And then drag up the radius a little bit, and the offset a little bit, and the intensity. You don't have to be too precise. And then you can see that the TV shadow is over here, but the girl shadow is over here. So we're going to change the angle so that it matches the TV shadow. Yeah, somewhere around there. That looks pretty good. And that's it. We've now applied a drop shadow to her. So we're going to exit out of that. And now you can enjoy your beautiful new pop-out effect. I hope you enjoyed our pop-out effect tutorial. If you want to see more great tutorials, be sure to subscribe to our channel. We come out with new videos all the time. So hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you in the next Affinity Revolution tutorial.